This tutorial is going to take you through the process of incorporating media into Google Sites. Now, the first thing we're going to talk about is adding images and video. And this seems really simple with Google Sites, and it is. In fact, it's simple with almost any project like this, but we're going to do something a little bit more interesting and actually get into the HTML. And the second thing is we're going to incorporate outside sites. And there's some weird things you have to know about working with iframes. And also, we're going to talk a little bit about really simple syndication and whether that works at all. And then we're going to talk about including Google Documents into the project file, which I think you'll find to be a very useful way to approach the use of your Google site. So the first thing we're going to do is learn how to add in some basic media, which would be images. So I'm on my home page here, and I'm going to click on Edit. And then I'm going to go through and insert an image. And you can see I've already got an uploaded image here, which is my profile pic from Rollins. But you can also do it from web address. And you can upload an image yourself if you choose to. And I want an alt text here, so I'm going to click on the image. And in my alt text, which means when I scroll over it, it's going to say something. I want it to say Rollins College official profile pic. All right, and you can notice it's gigantic here because it's a pretty high res file. So I'm going to click on small, the S. And it's left aligned, which is fine for me right now. And I want to have wrap text on so that the site doesn't actually fit to the image, but the image kind of fits around the site. And that's about right. And so that should work. And you can see here that it actually doesn't seem like it has turned the wrap on. And if I click back on the image, you can see, in fact, it hasn't. So I'm going to click on that, make sure that wrap is on so that it appears at the top. And then I can add in a couple of spaces. And let's say I want this to be a little lower for some reason. That isn't working either. So what you do if copy starts to act weird like this. So before it wasn't working, if you just kind of go back through and delete anything else that's around it, so press backspace or delete wherever else, then it should start working again. And sometimes it just gets a little weird. This is basically what I want. I'm gonna put in a couple of spaces. Welcome to the COM 302. Template site. I'm going to highlight that, and then I'm going to change my font a little bit to Georgia, and then 16 looks a little better for our purposes anyway. And then I'm going to show you what this looks like in HTML. And it's useful to be able to mess with HTML and know some basic things. And what I'm going to do here is show you if something weird happens, you can always edit it here. So now it looks difficult to see how this is working, but what I wanted to show you is that there's a couple of things here that we've got. So we've got a source here, which is an image source. So that means what web address is it drawing the image from, and it's drawing it from this place that I uploaded it. There's no border. Border equals zero. I can change this by changing it to one or two or three. The alt, the rollover, is Rollins College official profile pic, and it has a width of 133 pixels and a height of 200 pixels. And if you change that, which I think is really useful to be able to do, just make sure that you keep it in proportion. So you divide it out. So like 200 is to 250 as 133 is to whatever, right? So it would be, 200 divided by 250 equals 133 divided by X. And then you would multiply that out. You can see my font size is 10 point, but I can change that if I choose to. And then I've got some margins here, some space. 5 pixels in one direction, 10 pixels in the other, and 0 on the other two. Background color is transparent. And so again, you can change all of this if you choose to. This is just the image. And then I've got some divisions here. And then I've got my font, which is in Georgia. It's size 4. And I've got the welcome to the COM template site in the middle. And this means a non-breaking space. So there's a space in there. The breaking spaces are these. So if I wanted to make a space after, and you can see that's where I pressed enter to get those spaces, that's this div br slash div. So if you wanted to make another space manually, that's what you would put in there. But I'm not going to change anything here. I just wanted to show you how it works. And that's really useful when you're doing other kinds of things. So I'm going to click on save. And that works. So I want to show you a couple other media things. Right now, for instance, Rollins College goes to this specific Rollins page. Right? If I click on it, it's going to send me to Rollins. But what if I don't want to do that? What if I just want to have it embedded in here? Now, you can't do this with every site, but it's worth seeing that it's possible to do with certain sites. So let's say I wanted to change this out. I can go to Actions and then to Edit Site Layout. Then I can change this. I can go to Rollins and I can take this away. So I can add a page. And you can see, I don't have a page here. So I have to go through and make a page first. But I'm going to take out the Rollins College link first. I'm going to click on OK. And then Close. And then I'm going to go to Add a Page. And I'm going to name this just Other Links. And I'm going to put this at the top level, Create. And okay, now I've got my Other Links page here. And there's a couple of things that I can do in here. But I'm going to leave it as it is for now with all these little pieces like my attaching files and comments. Now, when you're doing your site for me, it's worth having this comments page here. When you're doing it professionally, obviously, it makes sense to pull this out. But I'm going to go to Insert, and I'm going to insert a gadget, and that's going to be an iframe. So I'll select. Now again, this doesn't always work, but it's worth at least playing with to see when it does. So I'm going to copy this, and I'm going to close it, and then I'm going to go back here and paste it in. I want to display a scroll bar. I want it to be this size. That's fine. I'll include a scroll bar when necessary, and I'm going to take the title off. So I'm going to click OK. And so now I've got this gadget here, and you can see it's a little weird in terms of the spacing. So maybe I'll go through and change this. First of all, I'm going to center it. I think I will keep it to the left. And I'm going to notice it's the same as with an image, right? And I'm going to switch this around. I'm going to say, let's do just a percent here. Let's make it a 100%. And then I'll change. Oh, maybe I'll leave the height at 600 pixels, and people can scroll through if they need to. And let's see what that does. So let's save this. Okay. So this is the right size, but I don't know if this is actually going to work or not. So let's go through and go to Preview Pages Viewer. And you can see it's just giving me this white blank page. And that means that when they were working on the page, they set it so that it was impossible to embed into other pages. And this is really common, especially with social media sites. So embedding doesn't always work. But certainly something else you could easily embed in there. And the one thing to remember is that it must be an HTTPS, not HTTP, to be able to successfully embed it. And that is probably why it didn't work in this case. So I'm not going to worry about that. I just wanted to let you know that it is possible to do that. But I tend to not do it simply because it does get a little weird. So I'm going to leave my Other Links page here, and then I'm going to go back through and go to Edit Site Layout, go back here, and add a URL that is Rollins College. Okay. And let's say I'm going to make that open. Oh, I'll open it in this window. That's fine. And then OK. So I do want to add a couple of other pages in here, obviously. So my social media site, I can go through and I can add another URL. And that would be text to display Facebook profile, or just Facebook, right? And then my URL here, I'll copy that, paste that in. Right, and maybe I'll have those open in a new window, maybe not, I'm not going to worry about it now. I'll add another URL that would be my academia page, and that's here. Okay, and then my LinkedIn page. then OK. Now, obviously, all of these are not really managed, right? So I want to send those up to social media and then in, right? So up and in, up and in. All right. So right now, that looks pretty decent. And obviously, until you close this, you can't actually see them. But I want to go through here, and I'm going to show you a little bit on this other link site, even though it doesn't really appear anywhere. Remember that you can go to page settings and take this stuff out. So I can take that other link's title out. I can take out the links to subpages. I can take out allow attachments. And all three of these I would always do. And in my case, I'm going to take out allow comments. You can put in a page description if you want. It's up to you. That's really good for when people are searching for your site. But that's what I'm going to go for. So for each page, I really want to go through and do that. So I'm going to go through this, my books page here, and I'm going to edit this as well. And I want to edit this with, I wanted to add another page in here. And that was media appearances. And I will create this. And then obviously I want to go through and save it. And I want to go through and edit site layout. And then add a page in. Should be my media appearances page. And I'm going to put this above the social media. And then OK. All right. So in media appearances, I can start putting in some videos, which is where I think I might be useful to have. So the first thing I want to do is to show you how to embed video. And there's a couple of ways you can do this. You can do this from YouTube itself. Or you can do this by uploading a video to Google Drive. And for me, in this case, with media appearances, I'm going to do it from Google Drive. But doing it from YouTube is just as simple. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to Insert. And then I'm going to choose Google Drive. And then Video. And notice you can also do this with a document. So you can have your resume in here. You can do it with a Google Drawing. You can add in a whole folder if you want somebody to be able to access a whole bunch of things that you've done. Images that you've uploaded, presentations that you've uploaded that you can scroll through, all sorts of really cool things. And for you, for this class, you'll have documents, you'll have presentations, and you'll have video. So in this case, I'm going to go to video. And I'm gonna have to have a ton of videos on my Google Drive. So I'm gonna type in ABC, and here's one I've got, one that's recent from June 20th, that is Facebook threats on Supreme Court. And then I'm gonna click on select, and you can say, okay, well, here's a title. ABC WFTV, and I'm gonna do June 16, 2014, Facebook threats. Maybe I'll do case on Facebook threats goes to Supreme Court. Then I've got my width and my height in pixels. I can click on save, and you can see here it has actually embedded my piece. And of course, I can then do the same thing, but like it could with any image. I can put a wrap on it to put text on the side here if I want to have a little caption. I can do other kind of, go back to my properties, all sorts of things. I can delete it. So that's really what I want. So I click on save, and what this is going to do is it's actually going to give me my title. And you can see here this is a pretty long title, so maybe I would want to actually have that on here in a description, and it embeds it in, right? So you have a lot of pretty powerful tools here to be able to include various media appearances or your videos that you produce for class or whatever. So that's a very, very useful tool, especially for documents like your resume and that kind of thing. Now, of course, you can also do this directly from YouTube. So I can go through and let's go to edit again. And let's, I'm gonna make a new space here. And then I'm going to insert a YouTube video. And this is really simple. You just do the URL of the YouTube video. So I'm going to jump to my channel And let's say I just take the Google Sites practicum from before, right click, copy link address, and paste that right in. And again, you can see video size, border, title, right? Google Sites practicum 2, and then save. And you can see that these aren't the same size, so I'd probably want to go through and at least make the widths the same in pixels, which is where HTML comes in very handy. If you want to just go through and see it all at once as opposed to going in individually, I can go to my HTML, and you can see here I've got, okay, width, everything, everywhere I have 425, and here I've got width of 480. So I'd want to go through, and let's say I want to keep the 480, I need to divide out to make sure that my height changes when I change this to 480. And you want to do this every time. So here I'd want to change to 480, and here I'd want to change to 480. So I'm going to cancel that for now, but just so you can see it. Here I've got my Google Sites practicum, and here I've got my Google Drive video. And that's basically all you do there. Now, if I wanted to add something else, so let's say I've got social media here, and let's say I've got a blog that I want to embed. I'm going to go to social media, and probably what I would do is I would add a page here that's to my blog, and then I would do this in that page. But just for the sake of time, I'm going to show you how to do it in the social media page. So I'm going to go to edit, and here I want to insert an RSS feed. So I'm going to go to more gadgets, and I'm going to scroll down into RSS, which again is really simple syndication, RSS feed. And there's a whole bunch of things that you can do here. There's a whole bunch of different ones here. So I'm going to go to select, and then again I can choose my height and my width, and there's an RSS feed URL. So I'm going to do this from, and there's colors and all that kind of stuff that you can choose. So I'm going to do this from one of my blogs that I've done for a previous class, because I'm not really a blogger. So I can, and you can, in some cases you can do this with Instagram, whatever. There's all sorts of little gadgets that are out there to pull from other sites, especially social media. The problem is social media doesn't really want you to do that, and they try to prevent it in any way possible, so they might always change it so that it won't work. So I recommend not doing that and just doing it from sites that you have more control on. So blog spots. Here's that blog. Again, this is an old blog. You can see I haven't edited this since 2010. But I want to actually go through and take the RSS feed from this blog. So to add an RSS feed, I'm going to go into my blog, and I'm going to go into, and this is different for every blog, but in Blogger it's kind of hidden. So I'm going to go into design, and I'm going to go to my layout, and I need to actually add a gadget in here. And what I'm going to do is add the feed, or sorry, the subscribe link. So I'm going to edit my subscribe to, save. You can see I've got my subscribe to thing here, save it, and then I can go back to view blog. And so down here, I have my subscription to the post, right? And when I go to my my Atom feed here, you can give this gives a really crazy little piece here. But what I want to do is actually go through and right click on this. And when I'm here, I can do to copy link address. And then when I have that address, I can go back into here and paste it. Right. So here's my post default. I noticed that, so here's the web address you would use if you were at Blogspot. And then I can go to OK. And so here I've got my RSS feed. So when I save, it's actually going to give me these little pieces. And there's a bunch of ways to do this. You can actually go through and get the images. There's all sorts of things that you can do with different blogs. Right? So you can do a slideshow. You can do the full post. I can make it a little bigger here, right? So the width is 100%. Height, let's make, I don't know, 400 pixels. Okay. Save it. And now you can see it's going to give me my images and a little bit of the copy that I've got in here and all of that, right? So there are basically some really interesting things that you can do in this piece that allow it to integrate into other sites. So what I want you to do is to make sure that you go through and add some things that either connect to your social media or connect to other kinds of media. So I want at least one image, at least one video, and some links to other sites or embedded other sites that really represent who you are and how you're connected to the community as a whole. That's it. Good luck.